Brethren, as we feed our body with its daily necessary nourishment, let us also feed our souls regularly with the Word of God. Come, let us partake of the food for our souls. My dear brothers and sisters, we are in the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And once again, I invite you to join me in reading, reflecting, and praying over the Gospel this Sunday. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out at dawn to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with them for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. Going out about 9 o'clock, the landowner saw others standing idle in the marketplace. And he said to them, "You too go into my vineyard, and I will give you what is just." So they went off, and he went out again around noon and around 3 o'clock and did likewise. Going out about 5 o'clock, the landowner found others standing around and said to them, "Why do you stand here idle all day?" They answered, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You too go into my vineyard." When it was evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his foreman, "Summon the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and ending with the first." When those who had started about 5 o'clock came, each received the usual daily wage. So when they first came, they thought that they would receive more, but each of them also got the usual wage. And on receiving it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last ones worked only for 1 hour, and you have made them equal to us, who bore the day's burden and the heat." He said to one of them in reply, "My friend, I am not cheating you. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what is yours and go. What if I wish to give this last one the same as you? Or am I not free to do as I wish with my own money? Are you envious because I am generous? Thus the last will be first, and the first will be last." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, as I have mentioned, we are in the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We are in Cycle A. And our Gospel this Sunday is taken from the Gospel of St. Matthew. We are in chapter 20, verses 1 to 16. And of course, here St. Matthew would tell us that as he was talking to his disciples, he gave them the parable. And the parable was about the kingdom of heaven. Now, of course, my dear brothers and sisters, perhaps upon listening to the story, the first reaction we could have is, the story seems to be unrealistic. The story seems to be imaginary. Well, of course, my dear brothers and sisters, we know that all the stories, all the parables that Jesus used in all of his teachings are all realistic. They are all based in his own experience. In fact, a lot of writers would say that one of the reasons why the teachings of Jesus are very effective because he uses stories, he uses examples based on real circumstances, on real experience. Now, we go back to the context of the story and we will understand that it is not imaginary, that Jesus did not make up the story. The story, the context of the story is, of course, Palestine. In Palestine during that time, not with our time right now, if you're looking for a job or perhaps you're somebody looking for a worker, most of the time what you do right now is go to an agency. You hire workers through an agency. But in Palestine during the time of Jesus, there were no agencies like that. So if you are an ordinary worker that you work every day, what do? Early in the morning, you bring all your tools and you go to the marketplace. And in the market, there's a certain space there where all the workers will stay. And anybody who needs a worker will just go to the marketplace. And of course, as we have seen our story, there was a landowner. In fact, he is a vineyard owner. He went early. What time of the day did he go? The Gospel of St. Matthew would tell us he went at dawn. Well, of course, my dear brothers and sisters, again, go back to the context in Palestine. The day begins. Allow me to say the day begins because we know that they follow the lunar calendar. Their day actually begins at 6 o'clock in the morning. But from our context, for our purposes, the day of work begins at 6 o'clock in the morning. That's why our gospel would tell us that the vineyard owner went to the marketplace at dawn. He was looking for workers. He went at dawn and he looked for workers, and anybody who found us workers in the marketplace during that time, he hired them with an agreement of the usual daily wage. Now, unfortunately, my dear brothers and sisters, in the entire story, in the entire parable, the Gospel of St. Matthew would not give us the actual amount of what was the usual daily wage. But during that time, the practice is the usual daily wage is 1 denarius. And so for our purposes of reflection, let's just say that they agreed the usual daily wage, they agreed for 1 denarius. And you know, if we in our time now divide the day by the hour, you have 6 o'clock in the morning, 7 o'clock in the morning, 8 o'clock in the morning, we know that in Palestine, they divide the day and the night, they divide it by intervals of 3 hours. Remember, I was telling you last time that the hour by night, they call it as watch. The first watch of the night is at 6 o'clock in the evening. The second watch of the night, 9 o'clock in the evening. Third watch of the night, midnight. Fourth watch of the night, 3 o'clock in the morning. That's why remember the story when Jesus walked over the water. The gospel would tell us that Jesus went down the mountain at the fourth watch of the night. Well, they divide the day and the night into intervals of 3 hours. No wonder in our gospel today, the landowner went to the marketplace at dawn so that by 6 o'clock he can already hire workers. He went out again at what time? 9 o'clock in the morning. He went to the marketplace again, noontime, 3 o'clock. And also, he went at around 5 o'clock, which is the 11th hour of the day. And of course, if during the dawn, when he hired workers, he agreed with them for the usual daily wage, the landowner went every time, 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, even 5 o'clock, even though just 1 hour is left for the working hour, and yet he still went to the marketplace looking for the worker. Why? Well, my dear brothers and sisters, as I have mentioned, the context is Palestine. And remember that the landowner, he is a vineyard owner. It's not any kind of land. He was a vineyard owner. And in Palestine, grapes, if you have a vineyard, grapes normally ripen by the end of September. And for them, by the time of October, it becomes rainy already. As most of the fruits would be, if the grapes are already ripened at the end of September, you have to harvest as fast as you could. Why? Because when the rains come and you are not done harvesting, whatever is still in the vine, whatever is left there, will be rotten. That's why before the rains come, you have to harvest as fast as you can, hoping that you can finish the harvest even before the rains would come, or else the rain would destroy your harvest. No wonder in the parable, again, going back to the story, that's why it's not imaginary, that's why it's a real story. That's why the landowner is not surprising that he would go every hour. He went dawn, 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock, and anybody who could be working, he would hire them going to the vineyard. Now, of course, at the end of the day, the Gospel of St. Matthew would tell us when it was evening, because the day begins 6 a.m., ends at 6 p.m., but actually it's the beginning of their day. But the end of the day of work, he summoned his foreman and told him to already pay the daily wage of the workers, beginning with the last group who came. What time did they come to work in the vineyard? 5 o'clock in the afternoon. And when they received their wage, how much did they receive? The usual daily wage, which is for our purposes, 1 denarius. Now, my dear friends, let's be honest with one another. If you are one of those who started working in the vineyard of that vineyard owner, at 6 o'clock in the morning, what would you be your reaction? If you see them already paying wages, those who work only at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and they receive 1 denarius, what would be your reaction? Even though you had an agreement with the owner that you will be paid 1 denarius. But since they were paid 1 denarius, it's a natural reaction. You must be expecting, wow, I will receive more than the agreement. I will receive more than 1 denarius, because if they receive 1 denarius, how about me who work at 6 o'clock in the morning up to 6 o'clock in the evening? I will definitely receive more than 1 denarius. Unfortunately, in the story, what happened? When they received their wages, they were given the usual daily wage, 1 denarius. As I said, normal reaction, you'll be complaining. This is unjust. And for us, perhaps, the first reaction we have is, that is injustice, Father. But you know, my dear brothers and sisters, the story, as I said, is taken in the Palestine, and Jesus at this point is talking to his disciples. Now, if he's talking to his disciples, of course, we know that the first ones to follow the Lord to be his disciples are the 12. And because they're the first ones, the first disciples of the Lord, what do you think is the tendency, human as we are, with all our weaknesses? Perhaps the tendency of the disciples is to feel very special, to say, we're ahead here, we're the first disciples, and to look down on others. And yet Jesus in our gospel today is telling us that even though you work 6 o'clock in the morning and they work at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, starting at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, you receive the same wage. You receive the same wage. Let's go to a bigger picture, my dear brothers and sisters. Yes, Jesus in our gospel today is talking to the disciples. And if you look at the bigger picture, he must have been talking about the Jews during that time. Because by the time that the gospel of St. Matthew was written, remember that Matthew wrote his gospel, his version of the gospel, around 90 AD, when there were already Gentiles joining the community. And the tendency during the time of the Jews who believed them on themselves as the chosen people of God, even from the Old Testament, remember, going back to the history of Israel, they have the tendency to look down upon the Gentiles. Remember, there was a controversy between the Gentiles and the Jews when the Gentiles started to follow the Lord. That's why they follow the community. That's why the tendency of the Jews to look down upon the Gentiles. Again, the Gospel of St. Matthew, our parable this Sunday, reminds them that in the kingdom of heaven, we'll be receiving the same denarius. Whether what time of day you entered, some of us might have entered or responded to the call of God from the young age. Some of us might have responded to the call of God even towards the end of our life. But the truth is, at the end of it all, we will be entering the same kingdom of heaven. That's even the bigger picture, the universal picture of our story today. That no matter what time of day you enter, what time of your life you enter the kingdom of heaven, you responded to the call of God, you will be receiving, you will be entering the same kingdom. In the kingdom of heaven, my dear brothers and sisters, there are no favorites. There are no special places for somebody or whatever. But in the kingdom of heaven, once we respond to the call of God, we will be receiving the same eternal peace in the kingdom of heaven. But you know, one thing that is very clear also in our gospel today, and what is that? In fact, our gospel is very rich in meaning, very rich in messages. What is that? The concept of justice. Notice that the gospel of St. Matthew in our gospel this Sunday uses what is just. I have given you what is just. Because for us, the usual definition of justice for us is giving to the person what he deserves. Giving to the person what he deserves. How do we do that? If you only work for 1 hour, you don't deserve 1 denarius, because 1 denarius is for the whole day's work and you only work for 1 hour. Therefore, you only deserve a fraction of the denarius. And yet, the gospel would tell us in the parable that the vineyard owner gave the person 1 denarius. You know why 1 denarius is the usual daily wage during that time? Because it is, according to history, that during the time of Jesus, for a man to survive for a day and his family, he needs at least one denarius. That's why the basis of assigning how much is the daily wage is based on what the person needs to survive a day. One day of work is one day survival. That's why the vineyard owner knows that if he gives that person who worked at 5 o'clock in the afternoon only a fraction of a denarius, tomorrow that worker and his family will go hungry, not enough to survive for the day. That's why to be just to the person, because he worked for you, you don't just give him what he deserves. He deserves just a fraction of a denarius. But that's not what he needs. He needs one denarius for him and his family to survive. Remember the story about, you know, the stranger who was passing by? And remember the Levite and the priest passed by. And then there was a stranger who took care of the one. He was an enemy. At that time, who is my neighbor? Remember Jesus was asked, who is a neighbor? The one who gave help. Because that is what is needed by your brother at that time. My dear brothers and sisters, if Jesus or God will just treat us with what we deserve, now I ask you, do you think we deserve to enter the kingdom of heaven? No. With all the sins and with all the limitations that we have and all the weaknesses that we have, nobody deserves to enter the kingdom of heaven. We are all sinful people. And yet, my dear brothers and sisters, God, because out of His great love for us, He knows that what we need is a kingdom of heaven. That's why at the end, we will enter the kingdom of heaven, not really because we deserve, but because God loves us and it is what we need. My dear brothers and sisters, if Jesus or God treats us that way, that He always gives us what we need, even though sometimes we do not deserve, as long as we try our best to really follow the will of the Lord and to be deserving of that grace, no matter how become undeserving we are, should we not treat one another that way? Should we not respond also to the needs of our brothers and sisters? Remember what Jesus said, that you will only be known to be my disciples if you have love for one another. My dear brothers and sisters, our gospel this Sunday reminds all of us that when God gives us, He gives us out of His great love for us, more than what we deserve, He gives us what we need. Will you do the same way for your brothers and sisters? Let us pray. Loving Father, as once again expressed in our gospel today, that there are many blessings you have given us, not because we are deserving, but because you love us and you know it is what we need. May we learn to be like you, loving Father. So open our eyes always to the needs of our brothers and sisters, especially in this time of pandemic. May we not only think about ourselves, but think of the need and safety of our brothers and sisters. And may we learn also to teach others to be good examples to others, that they too may become your disciples. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Have a blessed Sunday. God bless all of you. Thank you for partaking of this wonderful source of spiritual nourishment, the Word of God, the food for our souls. May the Almighty God and loving Father bless you.